churches have failed on people. That's right. The so-called black man, you are the lowest state, and you are the greatest thing God ever created.
That's right.
It's time for you men to come back in your place. Rule this earth like God made it for you to.
If you're not Israel, you ain't no kin to me. If you don't fit the 12, then you my enemy. We are in the land of our captivity. Someday we going home, so you best believe. If you're not Israel, you ain't no kin to me. If you don't fit the 12, then you my enemy. We are in the land of our captivity. Someday we going home, so you best believe.
Open your eyes, time to awake. We make up the 12 tribes of Israel today. We the real Jews, make no mistakes. They in our homeland, they phony, they faking. It ain't about color, it's more about race. God chose a nation to rule in this place. Jacob he loved, Esau he hate. You find that in Malachi 1 and verse 3. Trait, threats, you know, 3. Jerusalem is the motherland, above and it's free. That's Galatians, Quattro, B-A-N-C. Get it? Got it? Friend, they peach. If I gotta fast for a couple of weeks, just to get the kingdom, then I will let it be. I am keeping the laws, I keep every feast. Keep every Sabbath, break bread and I drink. Who's ready for Passover 2016? In the month of February, we gather in me. There's a whole lot of laughter, we dance and we sing. I'm living for 7 days out the week. Can't wait to see what the elders gon' teach. Pull out my Bible, then pull out my seat. That's a spiritual food, bon appetit. Some say truth hurts, read it and weep. If you ain't tryna hear me, then move up the street. When I exit your city, I dust off my feet. Lace up my boots, that's equipped with them clips. Lift up my voice like a trumpet in street. You can see my zeal, hear my zeal, all in my speech. See that I'm serious, I don't show no teeth. We are imperial, define it and read. And cannot be number like Santa.
Where's the black man at that's looking for salvation?
That's
where's
right.
The strong black man at that's going to rule his household? Where you at? We're looking for you.
What's your question?
Anyway, I got you later.
Yeah, come over here, man.
So my question, like, how come you say that Jesus is black? Because I'm the type of guy, like, looking for, like, the truth about religion stuff.
Understood.
They always say that Jesus, when I went through my own research, they said they were the first ship.
That man.
Jesus, right?
Slave ship, could be.
Yeah, that's right.
Could be.
But I'm starting to, which is I'm not really into it, but I do know because they told me about the prophets, the justice man. Because I really want to know more about the prophets. So I get baptized. So it always could be true. So you tell me where
guess what? We understood the faith. Every brother you see out here right now, you could not tell us that Jesus didn't look like that.
Right.
We learned this from our mama, our grandmother, our family and friends. We all had the same understanding because we learned that here in America. But the thing is, if you want to know anything about Jesus, do you go to a math book?
Exactly. I just come and say, huh?
Science book?
I love science, but science.
No, but do is a science book gonna tell you about Jesus?
No.
Where would you find anything pertaining to Jesus? In the Bible, right? So, in this Bible that discusses Jesus, it discusses how he looked.
Right.
It's written there. You want to know why we don't know? Because the church wasn't taught that. The preacher that's in there, when he went to theology school, that's not taught to them.
That's right.
They recite what they were learned in theology school.
Right.
And the white man did not teach them that verse. So you would never hear that verse. The white man never taught them the nationality verses. So you would never hear that verse.
Right.
So I'm going to show it to you. We made the statement that Jesus the Christ looks like you. Is that a lie? Or is it true? Let's prove it in the Bible. Let's go to Revelation, okay? Be patient with me for a second. Start at verse 1.
Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1.
So to reveal, the word revelation means to reveal. Reveal, that's the root word of it. Reveal, shun is the continuing of it. So I'm continuing to show you something. Read again.
The revelations of Jesus Christ.
So it's the revelation, the revealing, the continued revealing of Jesus Christ, right? I want you to jump up. Jump to verse
12.
11.
Verse 11.
Verse 10.
Verse 10. I was in the spirit of the Lord's day.
So John the Revelator was bringing this out on the Sabbath day, which is today. Another thing that our people don't keep, but we're going to touch on that later. So on the Lord's day, on the Sabbath day, read.
And heard behind me a great voice.
So I'm facing this way. I'm talking to you. And if somebody behind me starts speaking, what am I gonna do? Keep looking at you? I'm gonna turn around and see who is the person talking to me, right? So read the verse again. I'm trying to illustrate it so you can see this thing visually. You understand what I'm saying to you? Read it again.
I was in the spirit of the Lord's day.
On a Sabbath day.
And heard behind me.
And heard behind me what?
A great voice.
A great voice, read.
As of a trumpet saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. And what thou seest, write in a book.
So the voice that I turned around and spoke with told me to write down what I want. What you see. Write down what you see. Now, in today's term, if you was to write down what you see, what would they call it?
From Black History, from Black History.
Huh? If somebody was committing a crime and you saw, and the police came and asked you, hey, do you see what's going on? Yeah, I saw what's going on. What would you give them? Yeah, your eyewitness account. We're reading the eyewitness account of Jesus Christ. It's right. Being revealed to us. Read.
What thou seest, write in a book.
So what John the Revelator saw, he wrote it down. Eyewitness account. Read.
And sent it unto the seven churches.
Jump down.
Verse 12.
Verse 12.
And I turned to see the voice that spake with me.
So remember, I'm talking to you. Somebody started talking to me. Now I'm turned around to see who I'm talking to. So being turned, that means I didn't do this and got back looking at you. I turned my behind around and saw exactly what was gonna be described there. You understand what I'm saying to you? Read on.
And being turned,
uh-huh,
I saw seven golden candlesticks.
You see this? How many we got here? Seven. Golden candlestick is called a menorah. That's what he saw. Read.
And in the midst of the seven candlesticks.
Midst mean middle. Read.
One like unto the Son of Man.
So a lot of folks think we made this up. But we're trying to visually illustrate what's written here in the Bible.
Right.
What he saw in the middle of the seven golden candlestick was the Son of who? Read it again.
The Son of Man.
Talking about Jesus the Christ. Watch, he's going to describe this, what we got here. Read.
Clothed with a garment down to the foot.
So he wasn't butt naked, like a Cupid baby or something.
Yeah.
He had clothes on. He's writing down what he see. Read.
And girt about the paps with a golden girdle.
So he had a golden belt on around his long garment, his clothing. Read.
His head and his hairs.
Hold on. His hairs. The hair on his head, the hair on his fingers, the hairs with an S. Brother. So that's more than just your head. The hair on his head and the hair on his face, read.
Were white like wool.
What? Who has the woolly hair for? The texture. Do white people have your texture hair? You sure? No, nobody never seen it. It doesn't exist. He put that eyewitness account record in the scriptures for me and you today. Because
right.
Why is that there? There was a time gonna come where it was gonna be debated, what do Jesus look like?
Right.
A time was gonna come where they say nobody know what he looked like.
Right.
A time was gonna come where this image was gonna be all over the earth. So watch this, read it again.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Were white like wool. What's your name?
James.
James, you have hair just like Jesus Christ.
That's right.
The same hair everybody say that's nigga hair, that's nappy, BB shot, all these little derogatory terms. You have the hair of the Son of God.
Right.
We don't show you scripture. God has the same hair.
That's right.
So watch this. Hold your thought. Don't forget what you got to say, okay? Don't forget. Read.
As white as snow.
As white as snow. Hair, fully gray hair. That was his hair, the color of it. Like yours is black, as folks get old or wisdom come on, the hair get gray, right? ABC common sense, it's nothing deep, it ain't difficult, read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Do you drink wine? Liquor? Beer? Do beer change the color of your eyes? You ever seen somebody drinking?
Yeah.
You can tell their eyes get a little red, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Same thing. Christ drunk. His first miracle was what? Turning water into wine. Same thing. It's the whites of our eyes get a little red. Remember, he's turned around and given an account of how Jesus Christ looked. He's given it to you perfectly, from the hair on his head to his eyes. So he's being very detailed.
Right.
Keep that in mind. Read.
And his feet like unto fine bread.
So if you take your shoe off and show me your foot is the same color as your face. No matter who pull their feet out, your foot looked like your face. Right. So how did Jesus' feet look according to John 11 Revelator? Who was looking dead at him?
And his feet like unto fine bread.
Now what color is bread, you know? A penny. What color is a penny? Brown, right? Common sense. That's all around the world. You grab some brass, it's the same color. Right. So we got brown. Now, off the cuff, is white people brown? That eliminates them right there without even going no further. They're not brown. No shade of them is brown. Nothing brown about them. Just put some makeup on.
Spray tan.
Now keep it though. Hold on. We almost done with this eyewitness account of our Lord and Savior. Read.
As if they burned in a furnace.
So have you ever cooked some food before? Have you ever burned some food before? What color was it when we burned it? Black, right? So if you take a penny, which is already burned, and you burn it, you would get whiter? ABC common sense. So he let you know that Christ was a very dark-skinned man, like yourself.
Right.
Royal look, man.
Right.
Read.
And his voice as the sound of many waters.
So when he said his voice was the sound of many waters, what do you think that means? Christ spoke like a man.
Right.
Christ wasn't trying to put his soft, sexy voice on, trying to be a player.
Right.
He spoke like a man. You can hear him up the street speak.
Right.
He taught thousands.
Right.
He didn't have a PA system.
Right.
That means he had to speak loud. Right? So watch this. So from what the Bible just described, not my words, I'm reading to you verbatim. Do Jesus look like this? Or like this? Just off what you heard. Without digging, without going any deeper, just off what you just heard, do it look like this, what we done seen all our life? Or like this? You sure about that? One second, one more verse, and I want you to tell me what was in your mind. Give me 1 John 4. 1 John 4. All praises to the Most High, you was able to admit that. Because guess what? This Bible, the verse say this about that. A person who can't do that.
1 John chapter 4, verse 2. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God.
So guess what? If you are able to confess that Jesus came in the flesh, not that he just came on earth, but if you're able to confess, mean admit. When you confess something, you are admitting something. If you can admit that Jesus came in the flesh and that his flesh, his skin, looks like what the Bible says, read that Bible quote again.
Is of God.
You are of God. So watch this. If a person sit up here and say, well, I still believe he don't have no color, or I believe that he was white, or what did God say about that thought in the brain? Read.
Verse 3. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh,
even though the Bible said, but they still want to say, no, Jesus looked another way. Read.
Is not of God.
That person is not of God. They're not of God. Read.
And this is the spirit of Antichrist.
And they are the Antichrist.
Right.
So guess what? I guarantee you, you walk in any one of these churches, they'll never say that Jesus looked like this.
Right.
So what do that make them? Now look, even in the Seventh-day Adventist church, they won't admit this. Even in the Mormon church, my brother, they would not admit this. So what do that make the Mormon church? According to this verse, Antichrist. Anti means you're against.
Right. Against God.
They are against God, against Christ. It's not that hard to process and eliminate. We have to go as it is written. What's that is what it is. So, what you have to say?
That's the reason you get confusing.
What's confusing?
Is every. I don't need to call yourself a church, it's a religion. Every religion is a little thing different.
Ephesians 4.
So my question is, if Jesus was black, so how come he led us as black people?
There you go. Bring it out.
I'm so glad you said that. And when I did the research, all black people that call themselves Jewish, Jehovah's and all the religions, they were forcing like to call themselves. Like I was watching a video of a Jewish, was eating black
Muslim. Now you asked a good question. Jesus is black, why would he allow all this bad stuff to happen to us? Why, right? That's an excellent question. That's an now, would you believe the Bible answer? Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do.
Let me tell you something.
Why are you doing
this? You got a question about that?
Check it out. Hey, if you didn't believe in the Bible,
hey, no media is bad media.
Something in you keep drawing you to where the Bible's supposed to be yet, but it's not there. Now, guess what? You done landed in front of the Bible. You ain't never heard this before, have you? Have you ever heard this before? Why you hear that you was an Israelite? You tell me what you heard. No, what church touched you there?
No, I never met you like I'm talking to
only YouTube. Okay, I'm saying what church is set up out here?
No.
That's teaching you who you really are.
The only thing they say about you guys, always had all the bad thing about
you. Do you know the Bible? You know God is racist.
No, I don't
really care. So how much more? Hold on. Now wait a minute. Can I read it to you? Hold on. All because you. See, you keep. See, you know how it is. We're trying to process God through our brain. Instead of us going exactly the way He's saying He is, you're trying to break Him down to your rationale. You can't do that.
Right.
God don't fit in your box. I'm gonna show it to you. Hold on. Malachi, real quick.
This is the first time I heard
it. I'm going to prove it to you in the Bible. I'm going to show you. He made it too. And he made everybody on the face of the earth.
So, okay, he's like.
Hold on. All because he made him, do that mean that he can't choose now how he want to deal with what he made?
He's like.
Can he do that?
Yeah, okay. He's like,
hold on. Can he do that?
I don't think
so. Hold on. If you was God and you made a whole bunch of stuff, can't you decide what you want to play with, what you want to use, what you want to do?
Yeah.
Do you have to justify it to anybody because you like red better than blue?
Yeah.
Do you have to justify whether you want a peace standing up or peace sitting down?
Yes.
No, you decide that. God ain't who can question what God do? That's what I'm saying. That's what and that's in the Bible. Somebody trying to question God on why he do what he do. Now, for a minute, let me ask you a quick, because you asked a lot of questions. Let me go through the room and answer each one of these pieces, okay? What's it?
No, I'm going to change my
Stay with me.
Malachi chapter 3, verse 6. For I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed.
So one thing we got to realize that God don't change. So what we read in the Bible, if he said it in the Old Testament, New Testament, anyway, he said it, he's sticking by it, he mean it. Religion done changed what God done said. And have us start thinking a whole bunch of, let's go exactly what came out of his mouth. Because he said he don't change.
Right.
So you don't have to be confused. If he said it, that's how he still feel today.
Right.
It ain't changed. So watch this. Give me, hold on. I'm not telling you nothing. I'm going to read it to you, brother. Don't make it that I'm saying it. I want you to see it out the mouth of God. That's where the disconnect is. You're looking at the person that's saying it. What's that saying? Don't shoot the messenger?
Right.
The Bible is saying it. So watch this. Let's go to the beginning. Give me what's
76.
Deuteronomy. Because religion makes blacks, Hispanics, Native Indians believe that we are all equal. That God loves everybody. Right? That's what they tell us. And then you ask them what verse? John 3:16. Okay, we can break down John 3:16. But there's about 2,000 more pages in the Bible.
Right.
Is there any more verses that back that up?
Right.
I'm finna show it to you. Watch this.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
They don't listen. We don't listen to learn. We listen to rebuttal. So listen to learn for a second, all right?
For thou art an holy people.
Why don't you start up so we can know who he's talking to? We don't take the
one and one.
One and one.
Right. Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 1.
Read.
These be the word which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Jews, blacks, Hispanics, Native Indians, you are the Israelites.
That's right.
These are what the Lord's words that he said to you specifically. Brother,
right.
Watch this.
Amen. Check it, fly out.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
I want you to listen, brother.
For thou art an holy people.
So we are a holy people.
Right.
Watch this. Read.
Unto the Lord thy God, the Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Stop! Expect, if I got a whole lot of people, I got all these bricks are representative of people, right? And I chose this brick.
Check that flag, so black history.
Am I wrong for leaving those there? I want this brick for myself. Read that verse again.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee.
God hath chosen us. Read.
To be a special people unto himself.
Why he didn't choose everybody? He made everybody. Why is God choosing a particular people if he made everybody? He can do that. Who the hell is anybody to start telling God what he can and can't do?
Right.
He made us.
Right.
And guess what? He chose blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, chosen people, all praises. We fall on the right end of the stick.
Right.
Right.
Read again.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
The Lord thy God have chosen thee to be a special people.
A special people?
Unto himself.
For himself, read.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Above
right.
all people on the face of the earth. Not that racist. God himself is saying that a particular people he chosen is above everybody else.
Right.
Is that not racist? Yes or no? Yes or no? If a particular people is saying that they are better than another people, in today's terms, that's called racism. God been said that. He said that the Israelites is his chosen people above everybody on the face of the earth. He said that he don't change. So why in the world is that not being taught?
I don't got no money.
Is you clear on that? Now I can go over some old scriptures, but that might bog you down. I'm giving you a clear one showing you that they're in the Bible. And there's multitude more scriptures just like this.
Right.
Well, now guess what? I got a point on this. Give me Isaac. Yes. What I want?
I don't have nobody.
So maybe that one wasn't clear enough. I'm gonna give you another scripture that's a little bit more plain on how God feels about all the beautiful people he made on earth. The blacks, the whites, the Chinese, all of them, Arabs, all of them. How God feel about them now? He made them. That's not the for debate. That's 100%. He made everybody. But how do he feel about his creation? Hold on, I ain't even get to that part yet. I'm segueing to it right behind the question. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Listen, brother. Listen to learn.
Isaiah chapter 40, verse 15. Behold, the nations are as a drop of a bucket.
Verse 13. Oh, so stay with me.
Isaiah chapter 40, verse 13. Who have directed the spirit of the Lord.
So, and the Bible says, who has directed the spirit of the Lord? Do you know what it means to direct the spirit of the Lord? To tell God what to do. Who's telling God what to do? When you're being directed, hey, go over here, go over there, I want you to pick up that, do this. Who's telling God what to do? Nobody, right? We find ourselves trying to tell God to do a time, saying, wait, you can't do this, do that, why is this, why is that? That's us trying to direct God. We can't do that, but watch this.
Or being his counselor.
Ain't nobody up there telling God what moves to make. He do what he want to do, he's God. Read.
Have taught him with whom took he counsel.
Read again.
Verse 13. Whom have directed the spirit of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Or being his counselor.
Uh-huh.
Have taught him with whom took he counsel. And whom instructed him.
So who is sitting down giving God counsel on how to make moves in earth? Nobody. God do exactly what he want to do.
Right.
Whether anybody like it or not.
Right.
He don't have to justify himself, give you a reason. He does as he please. Period. Read on.
With whom took he counsel? Who instructed him and taught him in the path of judgment and taught him knowledge and showed to him the ways of understanding?
So who the one sat down and taught God? Who is God's teacher? Nobody.
Right.
It's a rhetorical question. That means nobody can tell God what to do.
Right.
Our job is to do exactly what he say do in the Bible. Read on.
Verse 15. Behold, the nations are as a...
Hold on. He said, behold now. With understanding God can do what he want to do. Now he's talking about the nations. That means everybody, right? The nations, right? Everybody. Read.
Behold, the nations are as a drop of a bucket and are counted as a small dust of the balance.
So wait a minute, now God is saying something about all the other nations outside of Israel. Everybody that's not an Israelite, God's saying that they are like a drop from a bucket. Now have you ever had a bucket of water? You ever walk with it? A little of the water fall out, right? Do you care about the water that fell out? Why? It don't mean nothing, right? Because you still got a bucket full of water. That's the analogy God is using. The nations are like a drop that fall out of a bucket of water. It means nothing to them.
Right.
If you have a scale, right, that you put stuff on to see how much you weigh, if it was dust on there, if you're worried about the dust, how much the dust weigh? No, you wipe it off, man, the dust gone. Dust don't mean nothing. That is what God is saying. But this is not told to church. Why? Because that's not the way the white man set it up for your preacher to learn.
Right.
He taught you to tell you feel good.
Right.
Make you feel real good. Keep bringing in your money. Stay in the sin. That's church 101.
Right.
Don't change. Bring me your change. And your wallet.
Right.
And your little boy.
Right.
And your girl.
Right.
Your wife if she look good.
Right.
Maybe your husband if he you know what. That's church 101. Read.
Behold, he taketh up the owl as a very little thing. And Lebanon is not sufficient to burn, nor the beast thereof sufficient for a burnt offering. All nations.
No, some of the nations.
All nations.
No, just the white people.
All nations.
White people, Chinese people, Arabs. Everybody that's not an Israelite. All nations. Free.
All nations before him.
All nations before God.
Are as nothing.
What?
Are as nothing.
Did you hear that? What did God say about the nation? You wouldn't believe that's in the Bible. The Bible, you say you don't believe it. God said the nations are nothing to him.
That's right.
Is he wrong? Why not wrong? Because he's God, brother.
That's right.
He can do what he want to do.
Right.
And the reason why we'll ever think that that's wrong
right.
is because we got this in our damn brain.
Right.
That's why we will sit up here and think that that's wrong.
Right.
Because that's not what we heard on TBN.
Right.
That's not what we heard in the Word Network. That's not what our granny taught us.
Right.
That ain't what our grandpa taught us.
Right.
But that's because they didn't read as it's written.
Right.
Hey, when you go to church, do you had the Bible open the whole time? Hey, this is what we do in church. Let's go to the book of whatever it is, read the verse. So I'm finna teach y'all about such and such and such. 30, 45, depending on how eloquent he is, an hour go past, choir come up, and then church service is over with. That's church.
Right.
He ain't going through the Bible giving you God's words. He found one scripture that he wanna use to go into, hey, give me that. What?
Her fiance went to a church, and if they church, they require a minimum of $10.
Where's that in the Bible?
Yes, and the Mormon required to give you like 10% of your salary.
Where's that in the Bible?
10%?
Yeah.
Where's that in the Bible? See, once again, guess what? Guess what the thought process is? We hear this stuff with no biblical proof to it. My mama gave money in church. My granny, everybody gave money in church, so. That's what we do.
Right.
You will never read here.
Right.
Now they're saying you're supposed to tithe, right? You heard it before, sister? Tithing. They'll tell our people that you must give your tithings and your offerings. Do anybody know what it is in the Bible? What is tithing?
Right.
We never question that.
Right.
Our family been doing it so long, and it's just a damn tradition.
Right. From a while, right?
Right, 14.
We're gonna get to it.
It's a way that you can help poor people, people that don't have, example, the Mormon, they say, if you,
let me tell you something about Mormon. Give me my bag real quick. Hey, you know that Mormon, because you're Bishop Mormon, I'm gonna get to a quick question real quick. Hey, you know Mormon said that being black is a curse?
Bring it out, Jew. Get it right there.
The Book of Mormon says, and there's a quote here, that there was a blackness that came upon all the children of Canaan, that they were despised among all people. What does that mean?
We believe that the blacks are the descendants of Cain, that the darkness was a curse that God placed upon them for the murder of Abel.
But Ariel, to say that black people are cursed, that sounds racist.
Perhaps it does. What can I say? I can't say things according to how one might interpret my response. I can't change the doctrines that Joseph Smith taught because those are unpopular today.
What color is you?
I'm black.
So you're going to a church where the doctrine is that they teach the members that looking like you is a curse from God.
Right.
Brother, come on, ABC common sense. When we don't read in the Bible that God himself looked like you. Jesus looked like you. Moses, Joseph, every great person in the Bible looked like you. So how can we sit inside a religion that tells us that the color of God, the color of the people of God, is a curse? That's the doctrine. You never heard that before?
So they say it was like
God. So is that some place you think God is in? Show me that in the Bible that being black is a curse.
Like I told you,
is being black a curse, sister?
Yeah,
you sure? You don't even need a scripture. You just know that can't be a curse. Yeah. That is common. So that's some place that you searching for God, brother. And guess what? You looking in all, how that song go? You looking in all the wrong places?
Right.
Today, accidentally, you stepped in front of the men of God.
Right.
And guess what? And you're more confused here than the Mormon church. The Mormon church, I guarantee you ain't asking no questions.
Yeah.
Whatever they bring out, that's God speaking. Even though we're showing you verse, going here and there, bringing out books, you still, I'm confused. I don't understand. Ain't nobody up here. We always up in church. And different branches of Christianity inherit the same thing.
Right.
And the reason why we ain't done, because we actually did what? Picked up the Bible and read it for ourselves. It's a saying, grab a gift, it's a saying. If you want to have anything from a black man, you do what? Ever heard? You want to have anything from a black man?
Oh, you need it.
Put it in the book. You never heard it before? That's true. We don't read. The most famous magazines for black folks, what? Vibe, Source. Jet. All of them, huh? Ain't no reading that. It's pictures.
Black Hair Magazine.
Black, yeah. Word Up. The Source, all the illustrated books that's pushed to us got a lot of pictures, very little words. Because we don't like to read. And they know we don't like to read. Anything dealing with that, you'll read some nonsense. We'll read the bibliography of Biggie Smalls. Read that damn thing from front to back. But the Bible, which is our historical book, nah, you don't read that, you know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, I know the blood of Jesus. I believe he died. I'm good, you know. But let's get tithing real quick. Give me that.
Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse 22. Thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed.
So watch this. We read about tithing. That was the law we had. God gave us the law of tithing. But was that tithing money? That's the thing that's the disconnect. Was that thing money? I want you to read it again.
Verse 22. Thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed, that the field bring it forth.
Hold on. You're supposed to tithe the increase of what? The field. Now, can y'all show me what field is shooting out $20 bills? $100 bills? Fives? Singles? Quarters? Nickels? Dimes? Do anybody know a money field? Please let me know, because I want to get some of the seeds. Anybody know where a money field is? What comes out the ground, sis? Food, vegetation. So the first thing of your crops, you gave 10% of that to the Lord as a sacrifice. That's in the Bible. That's not hard to understand. It was never money. It was of your resources that you grew, because we all had land.
Right.
Read the whole thing through, because many like, it had to be money, man. You mean telling me the preacher just got my $10 every week?
Right.
That's why he don't work. That's right. Why he driving you on the bus.
Right.
Watch this.
Verse 22. Thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed, that the field bringeth forth year by year.
That the field bringeth year by year. That's farming. The dealings of land and agriculture.
And thou shalt eat before the Lord thy God in the place which he shall choose.
So wait a minute. If that's where the tithe come from me giving the Lord what he blessed me with from the ground, where did it turn to money? Guess what he choose? Go back to Malachi. Because this is the excerpt scripture that they use to scare the hell out of you in church.
Right.
This is what they read in the church. How we know? Because we was there.
Mm-hmm.
We was there. We know the doctrine very well. Read.
Malachi chapter 3, verse 8.
This is the scripture.
You want to open it?
Yes.
Will a man rob God?
Uh-oh, wait a minute. You sitting in church? You like, hold on. Will a man rob God? I'm a man. I'm a woman. Hell no, he don't rob God. I love God. So he said, would a man rob God, Reed?
Yet ye have robbed me.
So how is I robbing God, Reed?
But ye say, wherein have we robbed thee?
Uh-huh.
In tithes and offerings.
So we like, wait a minute. I'm robbing God because I ain't giving God, because preacher said the tithe is money. So if I don't give God some money, I'm robbing him. I don't want to rob God. I love God. He's been too good for me. How much you need? $10 a week. Okay. 10%? Okay. 20%? Okay. Because I don't want to rob God. That's us in our ignorance, because we ain't read nothing.
Right.
We believe that that preacher that's in front of us is a man of God, or sometimes woman of God, and that they are giving us God's words very plainly,
right,
when that's not the case.
Right.
Let me read the first real quick for the sister right here.
Verse 9, ye are cursed with a curse.
Oh God, close the book. Hey, baby, give me my checkbook. Who want to be cursed? If somebody told you, hey man, if you ain't giving God his money, he don't curse you. Hey, how much God need? I ain't trying to be cursed. Everybody know a curse is a bad thing.
Right.
So they read that and it's done. I know, because that's, ain't that what they read in church, brothers?
Right.
And they close the book. They don't keep reading down. They don't precept to show you what tithe and offering was.
Look it up.
They read that and you dig deep. And fund this right here. That's why it's always hundreds of churches in black communities. Because you only can run that scam on simple Negroes.
Right.
You want to tell me these white neighborhoods with that winter garden on the first? You don't see church. You don't see one church, miles, church. Miles. They ain't got, I don't have churches. They don't believe in God. Because you can't run that hustle on them.
Right.
They read.
Right.
We don't read.
Right.
We go off emotions.
Right.
Choir, sing real good. Preacher got a little twang and a nice little suit. I feel like I'm serving God. Get my money. My conscience clip.
Right.
I don't have to do nothing. I don't have to change my life coming there. Lord, I was here today, Sunday morning. Gave my $10. I'm good for the rest of the week. That's not what the Most High is requiring of us Israelites, blacks, Hispanics, and Indians. Finish that verse.
Ye are cursed with a curse.
Uh-huh.
For ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse.
So that's why we bring all our money inside the church. Preacher beloved, he had 2-3 services, try and get you to come in the middle of the week. If he can get you in there three times a week, he add that thing up.
Right.
If I can get you to come in there 3 times a week, it's about 50 of y'all. Man, we can go and get that business we always want.
That's right.
We can go on vacation 2 times a year this time. It's about money, brother. Your soul means nothing.
Right.
The Bible calls them hirelings. They're in there. Where's our bucket at? You see a bucket out here? We're giving you the word of God at our own leisure, because that's what God commands us to do.
Right.
Where's our bucket? Have we asked you for money? Have we told you to come on in and look, we preach it to you, man. Put something in the bucket for us. Christ said, freely you have received, freely you give. But the preachers don't do that, because you can't maintain that unit for free.
Right.
You gotta pay rent. In order to make that mortgage or that rent, we need some of y'all to come in here and give that tithe money. $10 worth every Sunday.
So you forgot to answer that question.
So to answer your question about tithing, sis, you don't get no money. If our people stop giving tithes, you get a lot of money in your pocket just off that.
Right.
That'll be your every week stimulus package.
Yeah.
Man, you still talking about Jesus being black? We just showed you that. Hey, you gotta let that Mormon go, bro. Psalms 111, verse 10.
Make sure you give that.
Let me show you something
real quick. Check out.
You have to get give me that. Grab second S for real quick.
Is it the one that allowed that?
Watch this.
Read that. Psalms chapter 111, verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
So the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. What's the last part I read?
And a good understanding.
That's what you're lacking right now, man, a good understanding. Certain things come out and it's not processing, getting confused because of this right here, read.
Have all, and a good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
So you gotta start keeping God's laws, because a lot of this stuff ain't gonna click in your brain because you're full of sin. You're full of confusion. You got a whole lot of Mormon in you, Christianity, whatever else you into, and it's plugging up God's clear message to you.
Right.
You have to let all that go. Proverbs.
Second Exodus 14, 34.
Second Esdras, chapter 14, verse 34. Therefore, if so be that you will subdue your own understanding and reform your heart, you shall be kept alive.
Read again.
Therefore, if so be that you will subdue your own understanding.
You know what it means to subdue? When you subdue somebody, that means you grab them, right? You hold them. It says to subdue your own understanding. That means your own thoughts, how you think things should work in process, subdue that.
Right.
Hold that down. Put that to the side. And learn what God is saying. Because this is the program. This is the truth. This is the right answer. What you're thinking about ain't what it is. But what you're thinking about was placed there by who? Our oppressor. That's what being born again means. You have to start all over again now.
Right.
Get rid of all the stuff that you thought you knew and start learning afresh what actually God is talking about. You understand what I'm saying to you? And we had to do all the same thing. We were stuck on religion until we thought what it was. But guess what cleared it up? As we was reading, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little, there a little. We was reading, damn, so that wasn't it. That's what they said it was. But okay, the Bible say that. I'm rolling with that. Yeah, they said it was this in the church. But the Bible say this. I'm gonna roll with that. You understand what I'm saying to you?
Right.
That's what we do. We are not atheists, why? Deuteronomy 28. I'm going to show you why, because when we came in, we found out so many lies. We're like, damn, wait a minute. But why did us being proved to be wrong didn't change us to just disproving or disbelieving in God altogether? This is the reason why. Deuteronomy chapter 28, 15.
Bring it out. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments, and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So in the Bible, God said that his particular people, if they did not do what he said do, that he was going to do bad things to them. It's called curses. When you read from verse 14 on up, you read about the blessings, that if they did what God said do, been obedient, that he would have blessed them, put them in all different positions. So the reason why I can't say that I'm an atheist and don't believe in God is because of this verse right here. 68. Come on.
Verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
So where's Egypt? Right? The Lord said that he chose the people, that he was going to bring us, or bring them, we don't even know if it was us at the time, that he was going to bring them into Egypt again. When you read the Bible, examine history, the Israelites never went into Egypt again, especially now on those slave ships. So we're dealing with what is called a prophecy. You know what a prophecy is? Something to be predicted that's gonna happen in the future, right?
That it happened. That y'all are gonna go into slavery on ships.
And there ye shall be sold.
And when you get off them slave ships, you're gonna be what?
Ye shall be sold.
Uh-huh.
Unto your enemies.
Ooh, wait a minute. So we done processed all the other nations out and we're dealing with blacks, Hispanics. Who was the enemies that we were sold to? Say it again. Nobody's scared to say it, brother. You're amongst family. White people, right?
Right.
So watch this. This is in the Bible.
Right.
It happened. Therefore, there is a God.
Right.
Right.
There is a God.
That's right.
That's how I came to be an atheist.
Right.
Because what happened to a Pacific people happened.
Right.
Way before it ever even happened. It came to pass. It's a God. That's how I can't be an atheist. Should no black, Hispanic, Native Indian be walking around here saying they don't believe in God?
Right.
You are the physical proof that it's a God.
That's right.
Do you understand me, brother? Right. You are the proof that it's a God.
Right.
You being right here on the streets, we being right here on the streets, in a low condition proves that there is a God.
Right.
It's called a curse.
Right.
Us being on the bottom, racism, oppression, sex, all this stuff, that was written in the Bible, bro.
Right.
Deuteronomy 28. It talks about all that. But guess what? Religion was not sent to teach you none of this.
So I don't see anything about that.
I just told you what. It was not set up for you to be taught that.
Right.
That's why they make their own Bibles. That's why we have a new King James Version.
Right.
International Version.
Right.
A gay Bible now. They changing all over the place. To keep you away from what God is really saying.
Right.
Hey, you know what? The words are kind of old English. I don't understand. So give me the NIV. And the NIV take away 75% of the words in the Bible.
Right.
Why is that? Because everything predicates on keeping brothers asleep.
Right.
Y'all don't know how great y'all are.
Sure.
Y'all quit, get off these drugs, game banging, leave that religion and holidays alone, start doing what God say do.
Right.
You will see God move to you like this. But guess what? We love this more than we love God. You know that? For you to find out that church is wrong and still go, you love the white man more than God. For you to celebrate holidays and you can prove everyone to be demonic and satanic and this God, you still do it, shows you love the white man more than you love God. You understand what I'm saying to you? It's time for our brothers, Psalms 94:16. This is what we have to do, brothers. Our job is very important because it takes us to lead to get our women in order, to get our children in order, and to keep this nation in order. It starts with you. It starts with you, brother. But society will make you seem like you ain't nothing, just a nigga, you ain't nobody,
right.
You ain't got no jumper,
right.
You ain't got no 4-5 running, and so you can't rap nothing,
right.
You can't sing nothing,
right.
You ain't no actor, so you a nobody. According to God, guess what? You can't use none of them folks.
Right.
Right. He needs you. God needs you, bro. Understand that. So this is the call he put out for us, brother. Read that.
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16. For the Lord will not cast, verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
Call again, take your time.
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
So God is posing the question to you. Who's gonna rise up for you against the evildoers? You heard it. You said that you learned.
Right.
I said, God, I'm gonna stand for you. We ain't out here representing no Crips,
right.
No Bloods.
Right.
We ain't out here representing no Alphas, no Kappas. We ain't out here representing no church, no false religion. We out here representing our people, the Israelites, and our God.
That's right.
We answering the call, and we trying to get you brothers to answer the call.
Right.
Because we know the conclusion of this is us being on top.
Right.
You understand that?
Right.
Read that again.
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
Who's the evildoers? Amongst us. Of course, it's white folks, but you know what starts with us? These churches, man. Religion is working evil in our people.
That made you think that you could just say you love God and don't have to change yourself.
Right.
You can sell drugs and God still loves you.
Right.
You can rape women, God still loves you.
Right.
You can molest kids, God still loves you.
Right.
You can do any atrocity on the earth and God still loves you.
Right.
Show me that in the Bible. We don't build our lives around a lie.
Right.
Show me that. That you can do whatever you, show me come as you are in the Bible.
Right.
Show it to me. All this stuff we hear and make us feel good in our mess.
Right.
But God looking at you like, no, you gotta change.
Right.
It says the Bible tells me to repent and be ye therefore converted.
Right.
You have to change.
Right.
God just ain't accepting just anything yet. You keep on selling drugs. I love you anyway. Keep on smoking the weed.
Right.
Keep on being, nah, can't do it.
As long as right. You got a cross on.
Just, just put a cross on your neck. It's right. All good. Oh, just give a couple of dollars to the church, and you all good.
Right.
You have to change, brother. God is saying, who's going to stand up for me against the evil doers, right?
Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Who's working sin amongst our people? These churches, right? Politics. The educational system.
Drug dealers.
Pimps.
Right.
Rappers. These rappers are destroying our brothers.
Right.
It got you out here sagging pants.
Right.
It got our brothers wearing skirts.
Right.
Wearing deep V-necks.
Right.
What do a man look like anymore, man?
Right.
They got Will Smith's on wearing a dress.
Right.
But it's all good because it's Versace or Louis Vuitton.
Right. Right.
We getting destroyed. Getting Hosea 4:6, man.
Mm-hmm.
We being destroyed. Why? Because we running away from who we are.
Right.
You keep trying to be an African American, you don't be out here being a fag somewhere. I'm gonna take you straight.
Right.
Keep on running around thinking you a Haitian, a Jamaican, a Dominican, a Puerto Rican, and you don't be lost out here.
Right.
It's time for our people to wake up and return back to God.
Right.
And we
That's
are here
right.
to show it to you.
Right.
Yes, go and read that, man.
Hosea chapter 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Not everybody. He's saying his people. Not the whole world. His people.
Right.
We're the ones being destroyed because we lack what knowledge? Some of us got degrees, certificates.
Right.
Alright? We all went to the different levels of school.
Right.
That's not the knowledge that's destroying us. We know 1 + 1 = 2.
Right.
We know how many presidents it is and all that garbage.
Right.
What knowledge is you missing? Who you are. Because when you know who you are, you act a certain different way.
Right.
You don't see the Chinese folks doing what the hell we doing.
Right.
You don't see Arabs doing what we're doing.
Because
they know who they are.
Right.
But you see Negroes being the most coon and buffoon things ever.
Right.
Because we don't know who we are.
Right.
That's the truth, brother. So God said this in Psalms 97. These people in Hosea 4:6 are destroyed because they act on us. We have to keep the knowledge, brother. You see, brothers, they change themselves. Dude. It's something to be done, man. You ain't alone. And this is only a fraction of us.
Right.
It's brothers that understand this and standing for it.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying, too? You got a question, my brother?
So, yeah, you Puerto Rican.
Yeah, according to the Bible, man. You say you Puerto Rican? Where's your other son? You see yourself? You on him. Because you can't be, I know they say y'all Puerto Rican. You know what Puerto Rican means? It means rich port. You ain't a rich port.
Right.
It means rich port. All these names are horrible. Haitian.
Right.
Hell.
Means hell. Dominican.
Then tell them what the name African came from.
African. Leo Scipio African. African American. You so-called blacks. We have the most worst derogatory term name in the world.
Right.
African American is saying that you are the descendant of two white men.
Right.
Now can two men make a baby? That's not going around. That's impossible, man. But that shows the level of hatred and disgust they have for Judah.
Right.
We don't give you the name of two black men, you dirty dogs.
Two white men,
I'm sorry. So Africa is the name of Leo Scipio Africanus. You know who he was? Leo Scipio Africanus? He was a Greek navigator.
No, he was the Roman general.
Roman general, sorry. Roman general. America. America of Vespucci.
After you showed me that, I had one that looked it up.
That was heavy, wasn't it?
It was
and heavy. We got to put that down everywhere. Condition your brain. When you fill out for a job, boop, go to school, boop, when you fill out for a loan, boop, put that down. So in your mind, I'm a black African-American. I'm a Puerto Rican. I'm a Haitian. I'm a Dominican. When none of these names is who you are.
Right.
According to God, before slavery, before the conquistadors, before the French, before the Spanish, what did God call us? We had an identity. We were the Israelites.
That's right. Trap.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates from all our YouTube channels. Shalom.